Hey, how you doing, everybody? Welcome back to Kent's Food Review. Glad you're here tonight. We're at St. Augustine Seafood Company. They are Blue Point Oysters, so they're in the Long Island Sound, kind of around Connecticut. They definitely have a nice brightness to them. To me, definitely has a liquidity to it, kind of like a satin feel and look. These are definitely some cold water oysters right here. Definitely fresh with a mild flavor. Kind of a sweeter back taste on it. And that solidity just amplifies that amazing flavor of the oyster. The meat itself is really fine meat. It's just trying to melt some butter in your mouth. Really no texture to it at all. It's amazing oysters. Definitely glad I came down to St. Augustine Seafood Company. We've got some different sauces I'm gonna try out. They're all local sauces too. We've got La Florida pineapple guava. It's in the hot, it's not the habanero, it's the jalapeno sauce. Give it a little shake. These oysters are so delicious and have such a good salinity to it. You really don't wanna overpower with too much hot sauce, too much flavor. Even throwing some horseradish on is kind of overkill, as much as I love my horseradish and putting on the stuff. The second best thing about this place is they actually know how to shuck an oyster. You don't even have to try to release the meat from the shell. It's already released for you. It comes on a nice tray of ice. This place is definitely off to a good start with the food review. The habanero is really sweet and overpowers the whole entire oyster. Maybe not the best choice for an oyster, maybe a better choice for the fish, sandwiches, and everything else they got over here. But let's keep going up the line. Go next to a habanero golden pepper sauce. Another St. Augustine Seafood Company specialty. Merry Christmas, everyone, to all my viewers and all my friends out here. We're going to be in St. Augustine for the next few nights. We're going to go check out Firefly Pizzeria and also the Keani Room. We're going to go over there. And then just, you know, random spots here and there, see where we go. And just check everything out. Might as well enjoy a good old St. Augustine while we're down here. Really is awesome this time of year, besides for all the tourists. It's always packed no matter where you go. It's definitely not so much of a packed place, but it's in a nice local spot. It's hidden off the main track, kind of. It's just a little further of a walk than all the normal shops and Prohibition Kitchen and all that. Definitely would suggest coming down here to St. Augustine Seafood Company and getting some good seafood. There we go with the nice habanero sauce. Habanero is really good. It just doesn't belong in oysters, especially with good oysters. But it's a good sauce. It has a good spice with the habanero in it. Definitely amplified and kicking it up. Then you just got the straight up habanero fire sauce. Let's try this bad boy out. Some people go popping tags. I go popping hot sauces. It is what it is. We're not all the same. Definitely some good briny oysters. Definitely a delicious delicacy over here. I every oyster just melts in your mouth. It totally disintegrates. It's an amazing flavor. The salinity is like on point with it too. Nice cold water. So delicious. Wonderful Christmas song. Now that we cleanse out the palate a little bit, let's try some of these oysters. Very shiny and pretty in color. The meat just literally melts. I almost feel like I'm back home swimming in the ocean right now. It's crazy how this tastes. You can literally taste the difference of the water. Which is even a few different miles going up and down. Not a bad price to pay for good oysters, I tell you. There's plenty of liquid in there. Nice and gelatinous and satiny. That little tiny bit of bad flavor you get in your mouth is just because it's from New York. Long Island Sound Waters, you know, if you're up near Boston, you want to get that. But it is what it is. So far, so good. Off to a good start. Looking forward to what's next. Keep watching. All right, so we're done with St. Augustine's Seafood Company. I'll head out now to go find something better for dinner that would be a, I ain't got no ladder, sorry, bro. Really just not feeling the menu tonight with a whole bunch of seafood. Kind of want to go out and explore a little more. So, as delicious as the rest of that menu seems, with the fire daddle buffalo sauce that they have, which is just bomb, by the way. I did not put it on an oyster, but I tell you what, you need to go try that stuff. Get down to St. Augustine at this St. Augustine Fish Co. Definitely get that daddle buffalo sauce. Throw that on everything you eat there. It is just legit the best sauce that they have there. Definitely my favorite out of the three other sauces that they had. So St. Augustine Seafood Company, we're gonna give you a good solid 8.5. Those oysters were delicious. Definitely got them from Long Island Sound, Connecticut area. New York sucks, remember that. You heard it from me first. And till the next time, let's find a good spot to go for dinner. So our second stop tonight is St. George's Restaurant down at the end of the road. All the way down St. George's Street. Definitely looking forward to trying some of this beef. It came highly recommended from my waitress tonight. I was gonna get the lobster skewers, the lobster corn dog, but she steered me in the right direction on the tuna and beet sashimi. It's a thinly sliced tuna with roasted beets, some sashimi salad, some shallots, toasted sesame seeds, and a spicy
ponzu
sauce. She run away, she wants to go ahead and do it, mate. See ya. The beets are delicious, though. There's some really good melt in your mouth tuna right there. That was really good with that beet and the ponzu sauce. Definitely digging it. It tastes delicious. Nice way to start off with dinner. I'm gonna definitely get the short rib St. George tonight. That sounds delicious. Definitely in the mood for that. Looking forward to it. Hopefully the rest of this restaurant lives up to the hype and the expectation. definitely enjoying this place right now. Good quality food so far, good service, good drinks. And you get a nice spot at the top of the bar right here on the deck, overlooking Sainte-George Street and the rest of downtown St. Augustine. Definitely a nice, classy joint. I'm liking it. We got some, just missed Santa Claus walking up over there. I'll tell you what, that spicy ponzu sauce is something else. It's kind of like a daddle sauce. Definitely delicious, nice spice, good amount of heat. Not really overboard on it, very light on the back end, kind of a heat. Very delicious, and I'm looking forward to the rest of this meal. If you come here down to St. George Restaurant, definitely get the tuna and beet sashimi. You won't go wrong with it. You'll be missing out if you don't order it, for real. Lobster corn dog also sounds really good right now. I don't know why. It's a warm water lobster. We also got seared scallops with apples and fennel, a wet aged beef tenderloin bruschetta. Got a couple of good cheese boards over here too, but I'm not gonna sit here and smash on a cheese board, especially with these nuts that I'm allergic to, you know, I mean, just not gonna happen. So it is what it is. We also got some hummus and blue cheese balsamic house frites. And looks pretty good for a good variety of starters for your evening meal. All right, so we got the Sainte-George short rib. It's got very tender, slow cooked short ribs, perfectly paired with compressed fried potato and our signature incredibly addictive asparagus. So asparagus has peanuts in it, or some kind of nut in it. I'm not really sure. It does have peanuts in it. Thankfully, it's only peanuts and not anything else. The asparagus is pretty good, not gonna lie. Asparagus gets a fair review. Let's try the compressed potato. It's quite flaky and delicious. It's obviously deep fried. It's got definitely has some good chunks of sea salt up on there. Has a good thick crust, and the middle seems nice and soft. It's definitely something different. Definitely kind of reminds me of a scalloped potato a little bit. Just a layeredness in it with less creaminess. Perfect way to put it. It's delicious though. I mean, it just literally just flakes. You got one flake, two flakes, and it literally just flakes apart. It's pretty awesome. Then you get the good crisp crust on the outside of it. You really can't go wrong. I say it's all right, but it's pretty unique. I never had anything like this before. Never had compressed potatoes. I mean, it usually becomes in a baked potato, smashed potato, or home fries. I'm definitely on something new here. I'm liking it. Now we got the braised short rib. Kind of excited to try it. Hopefully it's tender and juicy and not fatty. That braised short rib definitely has some flavor to it. It's definitely tender as all hell. really just does break apart on the fork. It's not falling off the bone so easy. It's a little tough to get it off the bone, but once you get it off and get a piece of it, it breaks apart pretty well. What was that restaurant down in St. Petersburg, the Hard Rock Hotel, Capresso, something like that. Theirs would just fall right off the bone and definitely a little more, even just a little tiny bit of it. It's a little tough getting off, but once you get it apart, it's pretty damn good. I'm trying to go against with the grain too, so it breaks open easy. Not to put the phone down and grab a knife. Stand by. While we're in intermission, trying to break apart this beautiful shore rib I have, just check out the view up here. It's pretty awesome. Got all the Christmas lights up. Excuse the restaurante over there, but everywhere else, you know, pretty nice. You got the strip right here. Pretty local and close to everything. You can definitely people watch and enjoy a couple bites to eat, some drinks. They definitely gave me the best seat in the house, I gotta say. I mean, maybe that corner boot chair over there in the booth over there. But really over here, you really can't go wrong. Absolutely amazing service and amazing food. I'm definitely glad I stopped by here for dinner tonight. I'm kind of glad that the seafood wasn't hitting so much at the other place for me. And it just wasn't tantalizing my taste buds. But man, this beef is pretty darn good. Can't go wrong with a short rib. Can't really think of many other places I've had it where it's better than here. Plus Capresso. That place is pretty slamming too. I'm definitely looking forward to coming back this weekend though. I'm gonna go check out Black Fly. Gonna go to the Keani room. Who knows where else we'll stop along the way. There's definitely plenty of places for dessert around here too that I'd never go and stop at. I think I'm gonna definitely take advantage of that this weekend. I'm excited for this weekend to come. It's gonna be packed and be busy around here, but it's such a beautiful time of the year to be here. You can't beat the weather. It is a gorgeous 75 degrees right now, low humidity. You can literally walk around in shorts and a t-shirt and hang out on the beach and you won't even be cold. If you're not down in St. Augustine right now, you're missing out. You're really missing out on something special, I tell you. So get some more of this compressed potato. You can tell I'm digging the potato. Asparagus? Yeah. I'm like 60-40 on the asparagus. Maybe 70-30. The peanuts are a good kick to it. I do like that. It just feels like it blends in too much with the sauce on the short rib. It should be more of like a Thai style asparagus. But it is what it is. I would order it again. It's got a little saltiness to it. And the peanuts to help balance that flavor out. Nothing does the job it's supposed to do. The short rib's a little tough. It's not on the bone. That's probably why it's a little tough. But it's still very juicy and tantalizing my taste buds. Definitely enjoying this dinner. St. George's restaurant, give you a good 9.2. And there it is. There you have it. There's a review. Till the next time this weekend when we come back down, come check this place out. Until then, y'all, Merry Christmas. Peace. Alright, so I just left Sainte-George restaurant up there. I was literally right there with my waitress, Maddie. She was awesome and excellent, by the way. But I kept staring at this artifact that we have over here on 12 Sainte-George Street. Literally have a cannon. Spanish American War cannon sitting in the middle of the street.